Okay. So, good morning everyone. And today we will be starting with the topic which is immobilization of enzymes. So, in your syllabus, the topic number is 3, immobilization of enzymes, methods, properties, applications, advantages, disadvantages of immobilization, biosensors, biochips, and types and applications. Okay. So now what we are going to do is we are going to start with what do we mean exactly by biosensors. Sorry, not biosensors, immobilization of enzymes. And then we will go on to what are the different types of immobilization techniques, how we do it, then how we make biochips. And then finally, its advantages and disadvantages. Okay. So can anybody tell me what do you mean by immobilization of enzymes? Anybody? Yes.
Restrict movement of particular enzyme.
Restrict the movement of particular enzyme. Yes. Anything else? Anybody? Inactivation. No. In immobilization, we do not inactivate the enzymes. Never. Agar enzymes inactivate ho gaye, toh wo function kaise karenge na? So, basically, immobilization means confining or anchoring. Matlab, chahe wo cell ho ya enzyme ho. What we are doing is we are anchoring it to a material, inert material, such that the movement of that enzyme or the movement of that particular cell in the process will be restricted. Okay. Now, why do we do it? Why do we have to immobilize the enzymes? Any ideas? Speak, people.
To enhance the activity of enzyme.
Speak up.
So that it could perform greater amount of activity or increased activity.
Okay. To enhance the activity. Aniket, we cannot enhance the activity of enzyme or a cell by simply immobilizing it. So no, that is not an advantage. See, the basic advantages of this is a stable and more efficient in function. Matlab, it will be stabilized. The enzyme, please remember, has a half-life. Right? So after a particular amount in time, its activity decreases. But when we immobilize a particular enzyme, it becomes more stable and more efficient. Then it can be reused again and again. This is the most important part. Because see, when we have an enzyme and substrate reaction, we get product. And in doing so, the enzyme sometimes stops functioning or changes its conformation. So if we attach this particular enzyme to a substrate, then after this reaction, it will not be able to change the conformation and therefore it can be reused again. Another thing is the products are free from enzyme. See, when we have a liquid system, jaise ki for example, pani hai, usme ek enzyme dala, substrate dala. So what the enzyme will do, enzyme will attach to the substrate and start forming product. So what am I interested in? I am interested in the product. But now in my system, what I am going to have is product plus enzyme. Correct? And then again, I will have to filter the enzyme out. But if I immobilize the enzyme, then what will happen? In my medium, in my liquid, I will only have the product because I have immobilized the enzyme on the sidewalls of a container. Theek hai? So now what will happen? Yeah, fir I have immobilized them in the beads. So when I filter out, the beads will be separated out automatically and I will get only the liquid, which now will contain only my product and not my enzyme. So therefore, the purification cost of that product or that system will decrease. Okay? Then it is ideal for multi-enzyme reaction systems. What do I mean by multi-enzyme reaction systems? Is to create a product, I need, say, enzyme 1, enzyme 2, enzyme 3, and enzyme 4. So what is happening is I add a substrate. Enzyme 1 reacts with the substrate, gives me a product, which is a substrate for my enzyme 2. Okay, E2. Now E2 reacts with that product, gives P2. P2 reacts with E3, gives me my final product. Okay. So now what will happen if I immobilize all these E1, E2, E3 and E4 is in the liquid broth, now I will have product only. Plus sometimes what happens is these products are similar to one another. So aise bhi ho sakta hai ki mera P2 jo hai, instead of attaching to enzyme 3, it will go and attach to enzyme 2. But if I immobilize the enzymes, then due to structural differences, the products will only go and attach to the respective enzyme. Thereby, we will get more product or more purified product. Okay. Another property of immobilization or another advantage is that it is suitable for medical use and industrial use. मतलब अगर industrial process कोई लगाना है बहुत बड़े scale पर, तो अगर आप enzymes को immobilize कर दो, तो फिर आपका जो process है वो easily हो जाता है, उसका जो purification cost है product का, वो भी कम हो जाता है, and the ultimate aim or the ultimate end is a very purified product. And another advantage being the minimized effluent disposal problems. क्योंकि अगर मेरे को enzyme reuse करने को मिल रहा है, if I am using the enzyme again and again and again, then what will happen is my cost of buying a new enzyme decreases. The effluent that I had generated if I had not reused the enzyme would be more. And uska disposal jo hai wo zyada problematic hota. But since main 10 cycles ke liye ek hi same enzyme use kar rahi hu, to automatically mera sewage ka amount jo hai wo kam ho jata hai, and therefore there will be a minimal effluent that has to be disposed of. Clear? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so these ma'am. Are all the advantages of immobilizing the enzymes. Now tell me, what do you think should be the disadvantages of immobilizing the enzymes? Any ideas? क्या हो सकता है? Yes, what can be the disadvantages?
We will only get same type of products. There's no difference between the products.
Of course, because enzyme same hai, to same hi product milega. That is not a disadvantage. That is what any enzyme would do. If you give it S substrate, it is going to give you P only. It is not going to give you P1, P2 or P3 because enzymes are specific in action. It may affect the rate of reaction. Yes, Komal is right. Lower reaction rates can take place. It can affect the rate of reaction. Plus, it can also stop the biological activity of enzymes. Agar humne immobilization ka jo substrate hai, wo theek se choose nahi kiya, to phir what will happen? The activity will stop. Okay. Second thing, the most disadvantageous thing about immobilization is the cost of immobilization. Okay? Because the medium that we use or the substrate that we use for immobilization is very costly, like polyvinyl alcohols or for that matter calcium alginates. These are pretty expensive substrates, or silica gel for that matter. So the cost of production of your product increases. Gyanvi is asking, stability of enzyme may be affected. Yes, it will be affected. Why? Because there are, see, different methods of immobilization. Agar humne by chance adsorption use kiya, so it will change the charges on the molecule. So if that happens, then yes, the stability of the enzyme may be affected. But if we use a method which is called as entrapment, then I don't think so that the stability will be affected. So what is the preliminary criteria for immobilization is that you have to study properly the enzyme kinetics, plus you have to study properly the charges that are present on the enzyme for its proper function. क्योंकि आपको ऐसा मेथड ऐसा सबस्ट्रेट चूज करना है जिसकी वजह से आपका जो एंजाइम है उसको कुछ भी नहीं होना चाहिए. ओके, कैन चेंज द एंजाइम शेप और फंक्शन. इट मे चेंज, इट माइट नॉट चेंज, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन व्हाट प्रोसीजर ऑफ इमोबिलाइजेशन यू आर यूजिंग. ओके, so now I will be presenting you my screen. We will be talking about methods of immobilization. Okay. So can everybody see the paint? Say yes or no.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now we will be looking at methods of mobilization. Okay. The first method that we are going to talk about is adsorption. Okay. Now when I say adsorption, it means it is a physical binding of enzymes or cells. Okay. So for example, if this is my substrate here, okay, like this. Now for adsorption to take place, we have to remember that this surface here has to be inert. The materials that we can use are classified into two categories, basically organic and inorganic. So organic meaning it has to have carbon, like for example starch, or carboxymethyl cellulose, or cephalex for that matter. Inorganic means it should not have any carbon in it, like for example alumina or silica. Okay, now the forces that take action or the forces by which enzyme binds to a surface or to the matrix are van der Waals forces or by hydrogen bonding. Okay, so if say for example 1, 2, 3 and 4, these are my enzymes. So if I am talking about say van der Waals forces, the attachment will be something like this. Okay, this is a physical attraction, so something like this. This is how we draw for van der Waals forces. Okay, if Say, for example, I am talking about attachment by, say, for example, hydrogen bonds. Then what will happen if I have hydrogen bonding? Say, this is my enzyme 1, this is my enzyme 2, this is my enzyme 3. So hydrogen bonding will be between the charges. So my enzyme is all but negatively charged. Like this. So this is my enzyme ka charge. Okay. Now my surface to bond should have a positive charge. Okay. So I don't have a plus sign here. So I am denoting it with a star. Like this. Like this. So this is my hydrogen bonding. So these are not stars, this is a plus sign. So this is how you show adsorption if it is happening by hydrogen bonding. Okay. Now when we talk about adsorption, please remember that this adsorption is very weak in nature. So agar aapne us column ko zor se shake kar diya, ya fir us mixture ka pH change kar diya, तो ये जो बॉन्डिंग है, से बीट हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग और बीट वैंडरवॉल्स फोर्सेस, ये सब टूट जाएगा एंड द एंजाइम्स विल अगेन बिकम फ्री फ्लोटिंग इन द सॉल्यूशन. सो व्हाट डू वी डू टू अवॉइड दिस सिनेरियो? द सेकेंड मेथड इज यूज्ड व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज एंट्रैपमेंट, मीनिंग वी एंट्रैप और एनक्लोज the entire enzyme into a matrix, a gel matrix or a polymer matrix. So basically it is a, we basically keep the enzyme or jailed, basically we keep the enzyme jailed so that it will not move out in the liquid medium. So in case of entrapment, there are no forces which are playing any kind of action or which are doing anything. It is just that we catch a molecule of enzyme, we put it in a polymer matrix. It is like putting a person in the jail. The person can move around in the cell, but he or she will not be able to come out of that cell until and unless the police officer opens the door. So entrapment is that kind of a thing. Okay. The enzyme is retained while the substrate and the product molecules can pass through it, pass through the matrix. In this technique, which is commonly referred to as lattice entrapment, the enzyme or the cell is not subjected to strong forces of attraction. Okay. And there is no structural disorientation. So there are different ways in which you can entrap it, or there are different matrices in which we can entrap the molecule or the enzyme. Like we can entrap it in polyacrylamide gels. Then we can use collagen. We can use calcium alginate. We can use starch and we can use gelatin. Depending upon what kind of molecule you want to entrap, the choice of the matrices will vary. Okay. So if we are using gels, then in case of certain gels, the matrices are like this. Uneven matrices, the sizes are not even. So what will happen is, simply say if this is one cage, I will have one molecule of enzyme here, one molecule here, one molecule here, one molecule here. So this is entrapment by inclusion in the gel. So this is my gel fiber here and within it I have my enzyme molecules. There is another type of entrapment, which is entrapment in the fibers. So what will happen is, I will have two parallel fibers like this. and then in that my molecule will get entrapped like this. Okay, so there is no compartmentalization in case of entrapment in the fibers, but there is compartmentalization when we use entrapment by gels. Okay, another method is called entrapment in microcapsules. So what do? I create capsules like this, small capsules. Okay, like this. And in these capsules, my enzyme will get entrapped. Now the beauty of entrapment is that my product can move out of this matrix. My substrate can come inside the matrix, but my enzymes will not be able to leave the matrix. So for example, if this triangle here is my substrate, so my substrate can move inside. And if, for example, this is my product, wait, let's color it. So this red one is my substrate. This thing is my product. So the substrate reacts with enzyme and the enzyme will be able to come out. And the product will be then able to come out of the entrapment matrix. Okay. So this is all about entrapment. No, wait. Now we have to talk about microencapsulation. This thing. Okay. Now, when we talk about microencapsulation, or for that matter, encapsulation, please remember that there are two things that you have to remember. First, capsule will be formed if the capsule forming molecule has an hydrophobic end and has a hydrophilic end. Okay, the hydrophobic ends will come closer and form a capsule like this, such that the hydrophilic ends will be inside, and sorry, the hydrophobic ends will be inside and the hydrophilic ends would be outside. Okay, now entrapped cells, like for example, certain cells are generally entrapped using microencapsulation for the formation of the products like lactic acid, glutamic acids, malic acids, and sometimes aspartic acid also. Enzymological studies, yeah, enzymes, immobilization of enzymes is generally done by this kind of a structure, which is inclusion in the gels. But if you have a whole cell to be immobilized, then generally microencapsulation is done. Okay. In this process, a spherical particle is formed, whereby during formation of this sphere, whatever thing is in the liquid will get entrapped in the sphere. Okay. There are three distinct ways of microencapsulation. First is building of special membrane reactors. Second is formation of emulsions. And the third one is stabilization of emulsions to form microcapsules. So basically what you have to remember is, how do we make a microcapsule? So what I will do is, kaha gaya mera drawing board? Wait, just I'll increase this size first. So what we will do here is, say for example, this is my flask. Okay, isme mujhe capsules banane hain. So let me first draw my flask. Theek hai, isse acha main nahi bana sakta. Now this flask is going to contain a liquid, water basically. With some enzyme, sorry, with some enzyme molecule. So let's say this is my enzyme molecule. So this is my enzyme molecule, like this, okay? Now what I do is I add a matrice which has a hydrophobic end and a hydrophilic end, okay? Now since this is all water, the moment I drop it, what will happen is the hydrophobic ends will tend to come together, okay? And in doing so, they will entrap the enzyme like this. So now in my entrap molecule, what I will have is some water and an enzyme. So all the hydrophobic ends will come together and form such spheres in which automatically the enzyme molecule will get entrapped. Clear? Any doubts, please ask. Yes, people, good morning. Utha zara. Any doubts? Is it clear? Speak.
Ma'am, immobilization by capsule, so tumhi teen he sangitle na methods. Parat repeat karana.
Okay, first is building of special membrane reactors. Manje kai ki we will build a membrane reactor. So basically what I am doing is I am going to use a polymer which will come together to form a membrane, a impermeable membrane. Manje jache chote chote holes astil ki fakta tumcha substrate ani product aat bahar karu shakta. Second way of building a micro encapsule is by doing an emulsion. Emulsion means oil and water, it's a mix. And then you add an enzyme to it such that that oil will encapsulate the enzyme. And third is by stabilization of emulsions to form micro capsules. So what I do is I make an emulsion, I add another ingredient to it so that my oil and water do not separate out and I get a stable encapsulated system. Okay. Please remember these micro capsules are very, very small. Jo tumhi calcium alginate beads baghitle astil, that is very big. That is not micro encapsulation. That is enzyme inclusion in gels. Okay. Because the beads are very big. In case of micro encapsulation, you will not be able to see the capsules. Okay, they are very, very, very small, microscopic in nature. Clear? Yes? Okay. Now, the next way in which we can do immobilization is by forming covalent bonds. So the third type is covalent bond formation. Comparative to your adsorption, covalent bond formation is very strong. So again, how do I show it? It's like this. So this is my substrate and these are my enzymes, happy enzymes, and they form very strong covalent bonds with the inert surface. Okay, as compared to hydrogen bonds and van der Waals forces, covalent bonds are very strong. So even if you shake the entire system, this attachment is not going to come off. Okay? The covalent bond will be formed between the chemical groups of the enzymes and that of the support. Okay? Covalent binding is often associated with loss of some enzyme activity. बिकॉज सर्टन केमिकल बॉन्ड्स विल बी फॉर्म देयर बाय शिफ्टिंग और चेंजिंग द कॉन्फर्मेशन ऑफ एंजाइम अ लिटिल बिट. सो देयर आर हायर चांसेस ऑफ योर एंजाइम का फंक्शन गेटिंग लॉस्ट और द स्पीड और द काइनेटिक्स गेटिंग डिक्रीज्ड. ओके, नाउ देयर आर वेरियस मेथड्स बाय विच यू कैन मेक कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड्स और देयर आर वेरियस सब्सटेंसेस विच विल हेल्प इन बाइंडिंग और मेकिंग द कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड्स. सो द फर्स्ट मेथड by which you can make covalent bonds is cyanogen bromide activation. Now in case of cyanogen bromide activation, what we do is first we take a support which is inert, matlab jis pe koi bhi charge nahi hai, like cellulose ya sapphirose ya sapphadex. Now all these things will have a glycol group. Okay, now what do we do is once we make this inert matrix containing a glycol group, we dip it in cyanogen bromide. Okay, now cyanogen bromide, that is CnBr, when they bind to the enzymes, they will have charges and therefore the enzymes will then bind. So for example, again, if I have to show cyanogen bromide binding, then how do I show it? Wait, I will again increase the size of my canvas. So this is my inert support, sapphirose, sapphadex, etc. Now this support has to contain, whatever support you choose, have to contain what we call as glycol molecules. Okay, so this thing is going to contain an OH, this thing is going to contain an OH. Now what we do is, do I have an arrow? Yes, we dip this support in what we call as cyanogen bromide. Okay, CnBr. Now what will happen is this OH group will then react with cyanogen bromide. Okay, like this, say for example. And so what will happen is, instead of OH, now I will have O, another O here, and sorry, one O niche hoga tumhara OH yahan par OH. एंड यहां पर होगा तुम्हारा ओ के साथ, इंस्टेड ऑफ एच इट विल बी सी डबल बॉन्ड एन. ओके, सो नाउ दिस स्ट्रक्चर ओ सी एन विल अगेन रिएक्ट टुगेदर, दिस ओ सी एन एंड ओ एच. एंड finally what we will get is a structure which looks like this, O, another O, and a slanting line, and another bond, and here you will have C double bond and H. Okay, so final structure is this. सो दिस कंपाउंड, दिस इनर्ट कंपाउंड विल नाउ गेट सी डबल बॉन्ड एन एच, वेयर वट विल हैपन इज नाउ सी हैज अ वैलेंसी ऑफ 4. सो आई हैव वन ओ हियर. अगेन व्हेन इट रिएक्ट्स विद एन एंजाइम दिस बॉन्ड विल बी गॉन, एन एच विल गो अप एंड आई विल हैव एन एंजाइम बाइंडिंग हियर. So what will it look like is this. One line. One more line. One more line. So I will have my O here. I will have C match and behind here. And on top of C, I will have an H here and a line joining this. Okay, so basically we are going to have C double bond NH, one bond going to O and the remaining bond will be going to the enzyme. So this is how we use cyanogen bromide to activate an inert surface. Clear? Say yes or no.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so basically what we are doing in case of cyanogen bromide is we are using the carbon which is present in cyanogen bromide and using its valency, we are trying to attach an enzyme to the inert surface. Remember, this is a covalent bond and here at the bottom, you will have your OH back. So I have my O and H attached to this link here. Clear? So with this, we will be stopping for the day. Another 3 or 4 ways in which we can use covalent bonding that we will do tomorrow. Okay? If you have any doubts till now, please ask. No doubts?
No, ma'am.
Okay.